Well, it is December now, and if you still have a tag to fill, you might be thinking that your chances are pretty low. The rut is over for most of us, except for that second rut that we're not going to get into that, but I will link to a video the NDA just did. I'll put it down in the description below where they're talking about what the implications are if you are seeing this second rut activity where you hunt. But if you are still out there putting in the time trying to tag a nice buck, your chances may not be as bad as you might think. You just have to know how your tactics should change. If you know what you should be looking for, this post-rut period is not going to be as complicated or as bad as you might think it is. So in this video, we're going to go over 3 tips to tagging a nice buck in December. But before we go over these tips, do me a favor, and if this is your first time on my channel, hit that subscribe button. Make sure you click that bell icon so you can be notified every time I upload a video. And the first tip to finding good hunting in December is you need to know where those good late season food sources are. Just like the early season, deer are on the food to cover pattern, and the only difference is going to be what those food sources actually are. In the early season, deer are still seeking high protein food sources, your native forbs, your soybeans, clover, stuff like that. But in the fall, their need for protein drops and they switch to needing high carbohydrate, high fat for energy, and if it's past the rut, they need to put on some more weight to survive the cold part of the winter. These high carbohydrate, high fat foods are gonna be probably the most talked about food source, other than maybe your soybeans, and that's gonna be the acorns. But you cannot forget about woody browse. And as the season moves on, and I'm assuming you've got some fall food plots in because everybody does, those brassicas you planted are gonna start getting hit. But do not forget that the vast majority of a deer's diet this time of year is gonna be woody browse and your acorns. And when we're talking about acorns, everybody focuses in on white oak acorns because they're the deer's favorite acorn. However, we're talking about December, so all of your highly preferred white oak acorns are most likely gonna be gone. So knowing where your red oaks are, your red oaks that produced a good acorn crop, is gonna be key to finding good deer activity in December. And in fact, I would probably take hunting over a good crop of acorns this time of year than I would be hunting over my food plots. And this is especially true if you spent a lot of your time hunting around your food plots during the early season and the rut. Slip into those areas where you've got a good crop of red oak acorns and you are seeing some good sign, especially if these areas are near a good bedding area. And the second December deer hunting tip is you need to stick close to those bedding areas. Like I said earlier, deer are mostly back to a food to cover pattern. And if the last tip was covering one half of that equation, then the second tip has to be covering the last part. During the late season, temperatures are supposed to be colder, not so much this year, but December typically is colder. So you want to focus your efforts on finding the bedding areas on the south and west facing slopes because they get more sunshine. Deer just want to be there because they will be warmer. Look for those areas that have some growth about 4 foot off the ground and lower. And if you cannot find areas like this, then it's probably a good time to create some. Trust me, if you do not have these areas, your future hunting self will thank you for doing it now, because that will help you just be that much more successful in so many seasons to come. Find these areas and then stick to the outer edges of them. You don't wanna just go diving headfirst into the middle of them unless this is your last hunt. I know we're toward the end of the season, but we're not quite there yet, so you don't have to be super aggressive. Place yourself between the bedding area and the food source that you've hopefully identified from tip one, and only when the conditions allow you to cut them off going from that food back to the bedding, if it's a morning hunt. And if it's an evening, afternoon hunt, flip that scenario. They should be coming from bed to food. And I just can't help it to touch on the second rut a little bit. If you are expecting rutting activity, this little bit increase of rutting activity after the peak rut, you still want to key in on the bedding areas, because if you have it where you hunt, that's most likely where it's going to be. You just have to decide if it's a good thing or not. Again, watch that video that I'm going to link down below from the NDA for more information on the second rut. And the third tip to having success in December is you need to go sit in places where you have not sat before. Part of being a successful hunter is being able to adapt to new information, and even no information is information. If you have sat in your per usual spots all year long and you have not seen the buck you're after, or worse yet, you have not seen a deer at all, it is time to try some new things. Get out of those stands and try being a little more mobile. Maybe break out that climber you haven't used in a long time, or maybe you're a tree saddle guy and you have places you've picked out. It's time to try to go somewhere else. Get out of those old stands and find some places that you've not hunted before. Maybe you haven't been able to get a stand in there, so you need to sit on the ground. Go find some fresh sign and hunt around that. Not only will this help you get closer to the deer right now, this will also give you some valuable information for future seasons. Look for rubs that were made this year and maybe some scrapes that have recently been abandoned. Just because they're not making new rubs and freshening up those scrapes, the rutting activity is not continuing, it doesn't mean that they're just going to leave the area entirely. They liked that area for a reason and are spending at least some time there, and you should be too. So that was three tips that will hopefully help you have a successful December. If you've got any more late season tips you'd like to share, make sure you put those down in the comments below. Hit that like button if you liked this video, share it if you found it helpful, and make sure that you are subscribed so you can stay informed.